Alright, the assault on Griffith Park continues. So I believe our current... I believe we basically want to find our way to the radio tech... Wait, where am I right now? Hang on a second. No, I've been here before. Okay. Wow, it's just a really zoomed in chunk of the map, huh? It looks so small from here. So I believe we're here to find the radio tower at this point? Does this end over here, or is there more? Before you rises a massive stone wall, well fortified with gun towers and barbed wire. The gate's equally impressive, with heavy steel bands reinforcing sturdy oak timbers. Standing in front of the gate is a squad of knights of the Church Militant. No, there's not. I killed them already. Their leader, a giant Hispanic man with a thick black beard, salutes you. He does? That's weird. He looks like he could lift a car one-handed. Off to the side, you see bodies of aspirants all with their heads caved in. I'm being saluted right now? Oh god, what have I done? What did I just do? Oh. Ow, I don't want to be saluted anymore, this hurts. Probably should have gone the other way, in the side path. I think I just went out the front gate on accident. Well, I guess we're gonna have ourselves a fight. Can I even see? Who am I playing as right now, Gus? Gus can't see a single enemy right now, huh? Not even that guy right there? Even though it says I have a 100% chance of shooting him? How about this guy that also says I have a 100% chance of hitting? Okay. Vile cheats, you will die for this treachery. Weird, yeah, it says that I can't see them, but I can totally see them. God damn it, we're so trapped that I can't... Wait, what's going on here? So if I go out here, for example, what, like we can... I can just go attack this guy, right? Front door to the madhouse. There's our line of sight. Line of sight was freaking out and not working correctly in a weird way. I should go attack this other guy that has a lot of hit points left. Somebody with a pistol could make short of the work of all these characters, or her, actually. There we go. More experience! Yay! Do I want to move? No, the person behind me is the medic, so I don't need to move. We're good. I can crouch. Better accuracy on the future turns. Wow, that poor, poor melee character is having a tough time right now. Oh, well, he's alive at least. But yeah, he is down. He's very down. He's on the verge of dying. Let's get you further inside. I can't even walk out of here, right? Nope. So I'm just gonna go further inside to potentially get out of the way, but... it's Sally's turn next and she can't move. That is quite frustrating, actually. It sucks that I'm getting ferried through such a narrow path and I can't control what order people get to move in. Let's see, I could push... If I push forward, we can... Yeah, I can get a layout that makes a bit more sense for the rest of the party. Because then the father, brother's gonna move next. Father, brother, I forget. Well, this guy's using cover wrong, so let's punish him for that. This guy doesn't have burst fire. 100% chance of murder. The fight might actually be over already. Now there's two more. Oh, that guy's alive. And there's a guy over there. These guys aren't too bad. In fact, and by not too bad, I mean like they're easy to kill. I'm just gonna go flank this guy. Hey buddy, I can see you right here. Just thought I'd let you know that. Not enough for burst fire. All right. Still, sure he'll not take kindly to this. Bezeppi's next, so instead of you going next, let's have a. Ooh, I don't want to go too far because I use too much AP. Can I take cover over here? No. Well, let's spend like 4 AP moving forward. That leaves me 8. Which should be more than enough. There we go. And now Pazeppi can close things up. Hey, Pazeppi. You guys just had to attack us. Alright, how much experience we got this time? Wow. Sorry, Garza. You opened fire on us, Mr. Hispanic. I don't know. That's not supposed to sound really racist. It's just literally the only thing I know about this person is... He's the Hispanic. I'm like, okay, thanks for that. character trait game. This is one, literally his only trait that we have before he died. I'm trying to target my teammate here. Target NPCs, target PCs. Do I have to really specify which one needs a medkit right now? There we go. There we go, that's better than using... Did she only have advanced or master, or did she also have advanced? I don't remember. Either way, I just wanted to check my characters to see if I was using the lowest one I have. Spaz 12. I'm pretty sure I have that already. Just distribute these accordingly. Rosary beads, wine bottle. So they're mad that I... This must be the crucible out here that you're supposed to run through on your way in. Hello. Now that opens the gate to the bastion. Okay. We're good to go. Might as well level up a little bit. I think I'm done with trying to wait because it... you level up really fast lately. 33, so all you should have is skills, so we're just pumping into a perception. I mean, leadership. Yeah. That's the thing to do for that character. Help out our character, just help out our accuracy in combat. And you can't afford a point in anything and don't have a perk to spend, so we're done already. Cool. Pretty sure I want to go back in here. I'm trying to find my way to the radio tower, ultimately. So that was a weird, that was a fun surprise. Extra, like, what, like 1,000 experience practically for free? Or for cheap. Everyone reload real quick, we'll throw in a quick save. And we're gonna approach this gate over here that I think there were soldiers in front of it, but I didn't quite get around to it last time. This is the first episode of a new session. I've been doing like a week of videos per session lately. I just put my sniper in front. I didn't quite expect that combat to initiate that fast. That's a mason cannon, isn't it? Are there just turrets, maybe? Oh, they tried to kill my sniper, but she did her fainting spell to avoid the damage entirely. Ow. Okay, turret is not very threatening, to be fair. Okay, I'm not psyched about the turret, but it's still not the most threatening thing in the world. Let's put a dent in that if I can. Okay. These turrets are adorable, as it turns out. They try, I guess. Oh, it's stuck in there. Alright. I'll take a little bit of cover. Oh, we just lost control. With two leadership characters nearby, that's impressive. Dark Lord commands you to die. You can't do that much wrong, though, unless he decides to just start shooting at empty space again. I'm gonna go move forward with Pazeppi. Not that far forward, probably. There we go. I want her to finish off the turret, because that's what she specializes in. There we go. Good job. Take a knee, because I don't think she can make it... she probably could have made it to cover. Oh well. There's other people that are gonna help out. Hey, friend! Don't worry, we haven't forgotten about you. And ka-tunk! I'm anticipating finishing this entire game in today's session, which is exciting. I think I'm actually at that point now where the game's gonna be over soon. And it's always kinda cool to be at that point. Let's go encroach on their own cover. Hello, friend. I live here now. I have the strong gun on this character, so let's focus on the weaker, the more healthy one. There we go. I can scatter back and forth here. There we go. Some people might mistake when I'm happy about finishing a game, they might mistake that as me being tired of the game or something, which is definitely not the case in this game's case. It's just I'm so aware of how long ago I started it, and I feel guilty for how long it's taken me to finish it. So I'll be very satisfied when it's completed. We're getting in the ballpark of I think we passed 70 episodes. We're on our way to 80. It's a big game. Not like Witcher 3 big, but still pretty big. Black tunic. All right. Did he drop something way over here? No. Okay. I could cheese it and run all the way back, but let's go ahead and just use the medic on Purnell. Yeah, I have some regular old medic packs. We'll do an advanced. Ploop! There we go. And two more characters leveled up again. Here we go. What do I want to invest in now? Lockpicking and safe cracking are tempting. Field medic is plenty tempting because it affects how well you heal people. Shotgun kind of seems like an afterthought at this point, frankly. The other character is better at surgery. Yeah, let's go for safe cracking. Because when it's a lockpicking situation, I'm more likely to be able to just beat my way out of it if I need to. But if it's a safe, I might have to commit to, like, using bombs or something to get it open at that point. But whereas not being able to lockpick a gate means I guess I could just go attack that gate. No big deal. Giuseppe, you have 3 points. That is not great. Are you sure you leveled up? Is that the right character? I guess it was the right character. Does she only get 3 per turn? How high is her intelligence? Okay, intelligence, I guess. Huh. 3 seems low. Maybe I've just been misjudging what's normal for her for a while. It's fine. Onward. We have the radio tower gate key. So let's get this open. Bye. Alright, melee character first instead of sniper like last time. That was the wrong way to do that. Let's traverse. What do we have waiting for us out here? Oh yeah, look, my medic still has Z's over her head from when she fainted. It's not going away the way it should be, I guess. Let's quick save. New location and all that. Onward! What could go wrong, right? Giant rustling letters litter the mountainside, broken and illegible, while the framework that once held them is twisted and black, as if hit by a bomb. Oh, there they are. It says Hollywood. It's the Hollywood sign. Oops. Mixed up my controls there. Yep, there's Hollywood. That's a cool... They had to bring up this sign sooner or later, right? So it's kind of cool to encounter it. They're gonna bother sending us to LA. It makes sense to have that show up sooner or later. Are there gonna be more bad guys around here, or can I just use the radio tower and leave? Hello? I can't actually read what the word says. Oh. Random torch down here? Is there buried treasure? No, it's just disappointment. Buried disappointment. You hide that in the closet next to the emotional scarring. Come on, I got a big lightning hammer. And I'm jonesing to hammer. That doesn't make sense, but I don't really mind. Hey, Knight Sergeant Victory Rocco, what? Victory Rocco DeLeo. Are you alone? I think he's alone. Knight Sergeant Victory Rocco DeLeo. That's a funny name. It's about to be a funny splatter. Is the fight over now? That was worth it. Alright. Bye, Victory. What's over here? Chain link fence blocks the path. No, it doesn't. That chain link fence ain't blocking nobody. Is this the tower over here? Anyone gonna attack me for coming right around here? What? Ooh. That is zeolite. That is zeolite. That is zeolite. We need zeolite. That is good to find zeolite. Whoa. Wow, a lock. A lock on a medical container. That's either exceedingly rare or has never happened before. I can't remember which. Oh well, it's open. Anti-venom. That was anticlimactic a little bit. Another lock. Alright. Use your lockpicking skills. Person who is only good for healing and opening things. She has 2 talents. Opening inanimate objects and closing people. A working tumbler and explosive trap. Alright, well, everyone back away. Let Purnell take the explosion to the face. 70% chance of success means we're going to critically fail now. Nope, we're good. Alright. Get in there, Dolores. 26% chance of success. That's exceptionally small. That is exceptionally small. Come on. Not the first try. There we go, it's open. You know, actually there was nothing special here. I just opened it, tried to open it several times. 2 more bags of zeolite and scrap. We just picked up 5 bags of zeolite? Wow. We really did get everything we wanted. Just need to figure out how to get the actual... Oh god. We're fighting now, and my doctor's in front of the group, and there's a giant cannon over there. That's a lot of guys. Ow! Oh my god, there's a lot of them. Well, it's a good thing I quick save before coming this way. Oh, and the cannon's targeting my medic, of all people. Not the Gatling gun. Oh jeez, that actually hurt. Holy shit, Airton just straight up died. Airton has died and will always be remembered. Jesus Christ, I didn't even have control over him. Alrighty, so I just did this fight, but Airtown went and got executed straight up by one of the Gatling nuns, and then unfortunately the game just straight up crashed shortly thereafter, so here I am trying it again. But since I know they're there this time, at least I can open up with a volley, hopefully. Let's help you out real quick. It's a tiny medic pack on our sniper. Can at least try to do an opening shot this time. First of all, let's get everyone close by. Good. Get you behind cover and see if I can just get an opening shot over here. Hello, friend. Pew! Bam, one down out of the beginning of the fight. That'll help. I think he's behind cover this time too, so I don't have to move him at all. He'll be busy. But yeah, there's no way to get these characters into a proper configuration to help out against this encounter. Their side of the field is a whole bunch of cover. Our side of the field is an empty field with like one rock and with one thing here. So you can't exactly pre-orchestrate your cover the way I do in some other encounters. These guys are all close to being in melee range. I guess I should target the back characters mostly. With the sniper. Because they're the people that could shoot me while I'm approaching, but could potentially be harder to actually hurt in return. I can't hurt that character. They go behind cover then. Really hope Airtan doesn't waste all of his turns this time around like it did last time. He kept spending his turns like running into a wall and then stopping. I'm like, what are you doing? Oh no! No, that's not what you're supposed to be doing! It's like so many moments where he could have finished somebody off so easily but just didn't attack them. And I'm like, what are you doing? He's very strong as a melee character, partly because he just has a comically strong weapon, honestly. But the fact that you can't control him so often probably makes him not worth it. Actually, it might not be a terrible idea to switch back to, was it Corin Kane? Or Lexicanium? I think it was Corin Kane was the blade character. Yeah, the monk. The Lexicanium was a fist. That was a punchy character. Oh man, not being able to get in range properly with these melee characters is a bummer. This is decent. I'll be flanked by one character, but still covered against the other ones, but also be close enough to make proper use of my AP next time, hopefully. But the best that character's gonna be able to do. Here's some cover. Get me close enough to shoot at some of these guys. Can I shoot somebody that's weak? Nope. Well, I can go for 100% chance over here, at least. At least he's accurate, huh? Hello, you? Anyone being targeted yet? I don't see a target sign yet, so I guess no one's been marked quite yet. Let's hold back with the medic. Gonna get me in trouble if I go charging in this fast. Hello, Purnell. There's a lack of cover. Oh, I can only take cover in places that I won't be able to shoot at afterwards. I can take the opposing flanking position way over here. That'll probably offer some amount of versatility later. Who's being targeted? Sally is being targeted. Well, she's at least one character that's less likely to be straight up killed. Granted, she's going to be targeted here, which could be an impact on that. Wow, now that they're all gathering like that, it might be a decent idea to come out with the medic and try to shotgun them, actually. Alright. I'm gonna go attack. Yeah, let's get behind cover over here. Should I leave space for Sally? I can. Ah. Let's take cover over here. He's kind of vulnerable, so I want him to have cover from the machine guns in the background. The Gatling nuns. I'm still happy with that word. Ooh. Staying alive, huh? Let's see if we can cure that. Yeah, let's pick away about a bunch of these characters. If I target the ones that have full health still, damn. Then all the characters that don't, that have, all those pistol characters could just do like one shot at a time on a bunch of these low health characters and take out a bunch of them really quickly. There we go. Yeah, get Purnell in range. And he'll take some people out. I honestly don't even know. You're mostly shooting. Did he just? I think that they hit a knight and they hit the turret. Yeah, they have no idea what they're doing. I can hit the cannon from here. Let's focus on that for Pazeppi. The sniper's gonna join in soon. Okay, their whole party's getting pretty weak pretty fast. Ow. This could- they're shooting through Ayrton. Ayrton could be in danger here. They're gonna get a lot of turns. He's down. Eh, at least I'll probably stop shooting him now. It's probably still worth it, honestly. To take that one character down low so that everyone's low now. Ooh, yeah, machine gun character probably can target one people on one side. I think machine gun can target people on one side. I mean, SMG can, and pistol can target people on the other side. Probably go after this high hit point character over here. Tempting to just go after the cannon, too. Ah, this guy's an active threat to my characters, though. Yeah, let's take you out. Hello, you. Not quite a goodbye, but we're working on it. Whose turn is it? There we go. 98, you say? Yay. 74. There we go. We can just mow down their entire line now. I just destroyed Pazeppi's cover. Whoa, the game is running at like 2 frames per second right now. Now it's back. That was weird. This game is not... This type of game should not be intensive enough to be kicking the PS4's ass. Come on, come on, man. No excuses at some point. I think I'm gonna run up and use my shotgun on these guys and see what I can get out of that. Yeah, that'll be fun, right? I got one of them. That's something. Helps ensure that this part goes well. See, 4 AP per shot. I could flank for a better hit chance. Maybe even go over here. That's 5. Yeah, let's go over here. There we go. Oh shit, it's alive. I thought that was gonna be good enough. Alright, we need to work on... Yeah, not that. You need to... I'm gonna have you focus on the cannons now. Try to take this thing out before it actually shoots somebody. We're at risk. Good news is Sally's off in her own world, where she's not likely to be hurt by anybody. Oh, hey. Our other friend over there is mending right now. Oh, it's Pazeppi's turn. I got mixed up and thought I was on the shotgun character, and I was planning a completely different turn for a second there. Come on. A little more. A little more damage. Ow. Yeah, all the more reason to take out the cannon now, because everyone's taking damage. A lot of stuff happening to Sally that she might not be able to come back from. Lucky miss! Yay, luck! Luck. For one, you just don't give a fuck. Anymore, basically. Hey, knight. Should probably take this guy out first. Do it in a position that also takes cover, to some extent, perhaps? There's only so much I can do against these enemies, really. This is just as valid, mostly. Down! Alright. If I go over here, I'll at least have cover against the, nuns. I don't think there's much I can do to take cover from the Mason cannon. 62. If I go down here, I can aim better. It's gotta improve my chances, right? Ooh, the cannon. Yeah, let's go for the cannon. Damn, yeah, that was worthwhile. Lucky crit. Alright, let's have you. Well, that's a bad hit chance. But good chance of hitting the cannon. But I have to worry about hitting my teammate too. Let's move a little bit. See if I can aim this a little more conveniently. There we go. That's not bad. Let's see how that pans out. Oh, I hit the cannon at least. Alright, for now, let's finish it off. Save your teammate. Yay! Primary risk is gone now. Now save your other teammate. Yay! And in a moment here, Ayrton's probably just gonna get up on his own. So we have two Gatling nuns and one character that has like a one hit point left, basically. Let's get on the nuns. Oh, they are durable, aren't they? Not the most dangerous thing in the world. Taking 18 damage. I wish I could see anyone that those characters were actually— oh, Jesus Christ. They got a second action. See, when that happens, you can see who they're targeting, but any other part of the fight, you can't see who the character's targeting, and you're like, are they shooting someone right now? Alright, you can finish this guy off at least, right? It's the only— oh, she's in range too. You're gonna do low damage anyway. Let's have a guaranteed kill, because his action was gonna be next anyway. Solar powered. And she's very close to getting taken down. I think it's time for Sally to back the hell off. She's done poorly. Here we go. Oh, 67. 100%, because they're in the open. I would really prefer to land the shot, but this one's closer to dying. These characters are durable and difficult. Please don't— oh, shit. That's what I get for taking that gamble. Friendly fire. Well, shit. They have to reload? That's great. Whole turn spent reloading. Oh, you poor characters. Alright, I can at least try to help out Sally a bit, right? No. No, yes. She needs a lot of medicine. Wow. That's what the master does for her? I mean, the expert one? That's a high-level med kit that got her half of her health bar. She has a lot of health. I feel like I gotta take cover over here. But I also don't want to get shot. 6 AP. Let's see. If I spend 2 AP, which I can't use getting over there. But yeah, I'd prefer to spend 2 AP, because then I could shoot them. That's not going to be in range, probably. It's probably the best I can do. No, down here is probably pretty good. Take our shot. Hello, friend. I'm working on it. Hey, Giuseppe. You just plug away right now. There we go. They have to die a little bit eventually, right? Sally's mad. You made Sally angry. Sally is on the rapid approach. Sally is ready to murder. 41, it's getting worse. 87's way better. Don't friendly fire. Yay, see? Now that one's actually close to dying. That's a miss. That's good news. Ow. That's actually damaging. Do you get a second action? Jeez. Sally's having a bad time. And being surprisingly durable about the whole thing. Let's see, target NPCs, target PCs. We need to heal up our surgeon, because he's not gonna— no one else is gonna pick him up besides you. And I think he's actually dying right now. Work it. Ooh, free attack as Desperado. Fantastic. She just got split in half by a pistol shot. I don't even know how that works. I'm okay with it. Let's work on flanking. I believe that's the radio tower right there. Our ultimate objective. Pizzeppi angry, right, Pizzeppi? Show them why you're green. Ah. Ah? Ah? Hey, look, Airton woke up. I don't want to spend another medical kit, so let's just run the fuck away, because I don't really think he's going to make it in time for this fight. But he's on the verge of costing me another medical kit. Oh, are you going to shoot Sally if I do this? 41% is so bad. Got it. Cool. Yay, Brother Thomas has lost bleeding. That means he's out of blood now, forever. Ooh, and Ayrton can level up right now. Wow, that experience, Crawl. Look at that go. 1,400. That actually might be the most experience we've ever gotten in a fight. What's that skull say? Headache. Minus 1 meter perception radius, that's actually not that big of a deal, and it's gonna be gone in a few minutes anyway. Those status effects really only affect combat. Once you're out of combat, the time passes relatively quickly. Bladed weapons up? Absolutely. Seems like the only reasonable thing to do with you. Alright. Ayrton, you lived! You got hurt just almost as much as last time. Well, actually, not really. You mended on your own. Mason cannon engine. Priest battle vest, communion wafer. So many wafers, it's getting weird. Scripture notes, crumpled page of musings and notes from a God's militia member. Here we go. Some more rosary beads and nonsense. Alright, let's go ahead and quick save. And then enjoy our victory as we install this radio dish at long last. Enjoy, Sally. Repeater unit, go! We've attached a repeater to the transmitter in Griffith. Over.
Roger, Echo 1. Stand by while I make contact with Raven Citadel. If that tower can't push our signal to Arizona, then nothing will. Ranger Citadel, this is Santa Fe Base. Do you read? Over. I say again, Ranger Citadel, this is Santa Fe Base. Come in. Over.
This is General Vargas speaking. Woodson, is that you?
10-4, General. I have Team Echo listening in. Thanks to Team Echo, we were able to relay our signal from a powerful tower in Griffith. Over.
Roger that. Sounds like you and Team Echo have been holding your own. What's the status of Team Foxtrot? Over.
I'm sorry to say Team Foxtrot is KIA. Those of us who stayed back at Santa Fe were overrun by mutant dogs. Only reason I'm alive is because Team Echo showed up to save my hide. As for the down chopper, well, Team Echo has been running the investigation. I'll let them give you the sit rep. They've also run into a new threat that you're going to want to hear about. Patching them in now.
This is Team Echo.
Copy that. We'll get Mer-Captain working on the schematics for your rad suits. Now, what's this new threat that Woodson mentioned? Over.
They kind of skipped ahead on the dialogue there. It says, this is Team Echo 1. We ran out of fuel and our chopper went down in Santa Fe Base. We've been unable to reach Seal Beach on foot. There's heavy radiation to the south. We're working on upgrading our rad suits. Over. Then he said all that. Some nut job named Matthias has it in for the Rangers. He seems to know about our Ranger Citadel and he's been promising to retaliate against us for killing his children.
If I had 5 scrap for every nut job that made threats against us, I'd be retired by now. But I think you're right about this Matthias nut job. He sounds like the type who'd be behind the attack on Team Foxtrot. I'll start calling in some favors over here in Arizona and make sure we have enough resources to handle any surprises. Keep digging up what you can on this Matthias character and keep us posted on the status of Team Foxtrot. Anything else to report? Over.
Negative, over.
Roger, Echo 1. I'm getting word from Mer-Captain about those schematics for your rad suits. Sending them over to Woodson now. Woodson, confirm receipt. Over.
This is Woodson. Schematics confirmed. Over.
Roger that. I'll let Woodson go over the schematic details with you, Team Echo. You stay safe and keep doing us proud. Ranger Citadel out.
This is Woodson. Good news, Echo One. I was right about the zeolite. The bad news is we're gonna need a lot of it. According to Merc Captain's calculations, we're gonna need 50 pounds of medical-grade zeolite. I'll start prepping things on my end. Once you have the zeolite, head back to Santa Fe and I'll take care of your upgrades. Copy? Over.
Good copy, over.
10-4, Echo One. Santa Fe base out.
Let's investigate then. What's in my inventory? 10 pounds. Yeah, I already had zeolite from elsewhere, but I just got 50 pounds since I got here. That was no big deal. Alright, we're ready to head out then. We are all set. We'll go revisit the doctor, get some medical attention, and see if they whole treaty is good, and we'll maybe stop getting attacked by God's militia. Here we go. That's a good sign. Welcome, Rangers. We're glad to have you here to witness this. Without you, it could have never happened. After you, Mistress. With our signature, Hollywood officially ends its hostilities with the Bastion of Faith. With the signature, the Bastion of Faith officially ends its hostilities with Hollywood. May peace prevail. Rangers, we are in your debt. Thank you again, and good luck wherever you go. Please, take this small token of my appreciation. Logbook updated, and... anything else? Logbook updated. And... 3,000 scrap. How much do we have now? 23,000 scrap. I was really scraping by trying to get any currency for like 90% of this playthrough, and now I have more than I think I even can spend. I guess I'll just buy all the ammo available. Let's go. Let's level up Sally. She was very hurt. Level 35. She can put a point into blunt weapons. Yeah. I think we have a big fight coming ahead of us. So anything that can increase my offensive skills, the better. Farewell, Rangers. Yep, that's all they have to say. Alright. So, on my way out, I'm gonna go ahead and visit the doctor. And maybe buy some extra ammo and upgrade any weapons along the way. But then we're probably just gonna head right back to... I always want to say Ranger Citadel, but we're gonna head back to Santa Fe base. And figure out the whole zeolite situation. Are these people still imprisoned? Yeah, there's still a person in there. Why are there still people imprisoned here of all places? That's the weird part to me. Anyway, all right. Catching up went pretty well. Everyone's healed. I got some 45 and 50 ammo. The entire party now has at least 7 armor value on their characters, of like what they're wearing right now. Most of them have that like. That weightless 7 armor one, which is nice. All around pretty good. I bought a ton of expert and master both surgery and medical items, and I got experimental painkillers for almost everybody in the party. And we still have 17,000 scrap. So pretty much set to go. So next episode, we're gonna go hand in our zeolite. And begin the what I think is the final leg of the journey. Thanks for watching, like always, guys, and I'll see you next time.